Find out how this ordinary girl became an inspiration for every animal lover with her extraordinary acts of kindness. The idea that some lives matter less is the root of all the wrong in this world, said Dr. Paul Edward Farmer, a famous anthropologist, physician, and a humanitarian working for the rightful cause, and said to be the man who would cure the world. We've no doubt that there's a huge crowd who works for animal rescue, cares, and further. However, there's more need to raise awareness about our loving buddies, especially about not interfering in their natural habitat and their rights to live. Such is the story of a girl who fought several setbacks, yet it is the amazing happening of events and decisions of this girl that made her shine brighter than anyone else. This story is close to my heart and is sure to touch yours as well. And if not, then wait for the videos along the way. However, first of all, it's important that everyone knows more about the harsh environment and a dreadful end these animals meet when there's always an easier way for it. So don't skip through and don't rush, as that's possibly the truth behind your daily food products. In the words of Philip Wallen, former VP of Citibank and GM of Citicorp, a philanthropist, animal rights today is now the greatest social justice issue since the abolition of slavery. When our nature came into existence, it granted equal rights to each species, including plants and the trees. But it didn't take too long for the human minds to rule over the rest. The ruling is a whole different story, and now we've crossed limits where many species are on the verge of extinction, and the destroyers are acting as the saviors, which is quite ironical. We've experimented on the helpless, hunted the wild, trapped the rare, and ate the rest. Though we have enforced laws for the rights of animals, and investigators are spread all over the US states with different roles assigned. Private organizations, too, have started showing interest in care and shelter programs. Besides the efforts, we fall short of results. We being meat consumers makes it hard to get attached to them, never to deny their rights to live in free quarters, free them from steroids and euthanasia. Our forefathers honored the horse as a favorite animal like dogs and cats when this country was founded, are the words of conservatives. On the basis of a national poll, the American Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, ASPCA, stated in 2012 that 80% of Americans were against horse butchering. A few years back, when the government passed the law that eventually banned horse slaughtering, the last existing slaughterhouses were shut down. Still, American horses are regularly transported across the border to Mexican and Canadian slaughterhouses, from where the meat is exported around the globe to the countries where hippophagy is legal. The ban is extended until October this year, but people are in the favor of a permanent ban, including the prohibition of transportation of horses outside of America. Chickens used to spend their lives together digging for food, playing in the muddy water, roosting early morning, and lying under the sun, until their unaccountable descendants spent a life to be slaughtered in the exhausted halls or kept for laying eggs. We doubt they themselves might have forgotten their traits. Undeniably, chickens are the most abused creatures on Earth. Since birth, baby chicks are separated from their mothers where they live on their own. A majority of these animals spend their lives in complete jails. In the United States, more than 9 billion chickens are killed each year. Approximately 305 million hens are used for their eggs, and the numbers increase every year. Their meat and eggs are consumed much more than any other animal, yet there's no law to save them, turkeys, or any other birds in the humane rights. When actually most of the Americans are willing to support this cause. Want to know more about the extreme disaster? More than 200 million chicks just born are buried alive or left in bags to suffocate, as they're neither required by the meat-producing industries nor for breeding. The rest, allowed to live for a while, are soon transported to slaughterhouses in small crates, stuffed with many chickens in one. Don't forget that transportation continues in extreme climates for long distances. Millions die of the stress, and the rest suffer injuries, broken wings and legs due to all the inhumane handling. After reaching the place, their throats are cut while legs are shackled, and then remove their feathers, they're hanged under hot water. Nothing new for slaughterhouses to directly put them through hot water if the throat cutter's missing, while they're still alive. How should I describe the ordeal that these friendly, loving souls go through? Yes, it could get worse when they're hit with a bullet when shot, and sometimes shot twice or thrice. And most of the time, all this goes on when the poor cows are again in their senses and conscious. Surviving merely on dairy sheds and then facing the hellish rides to these slaughterhouses, the journey can sometimes take days. Meanwhile, they stay typically without food or water for 40-50 cows with no space to move. While they collapse in the hot weather, the cold climate freezes many on the sides of trucks, and they're pulled out with crowbars. When they're unable to walk out due to weakness, the downers, as they're called in the industry, are dragged from the trucks. In so much pain, is the word pain even enough to describe it? The pigs are no different from the rest, and they stand right in the queue of injustice with the piglets kept away from their mothers since birth. They blink, they make noises, their head moves, their eyes are wide and looking around. They die one by one, is one experience shared in words. Is that the only fate that awaits cattle? This article gave us an experience through the unacceptable reality. As we told you, the story is about change and most of all about a girl who started a wave of change from her end. We love them, we adore them, but we don't do much for them. Caitlin Stewart, a New Jersey-raised 32-year-old whose inspiring story we're about to share with you, was just an ordinary girl till her 20s. Caitlin was an animal lover since childhood when the summers were spent horse riding. She loved them all, but horses had been her first love. But something stopped her from getting too close to them. She admits that she always wanted to work for their betterment, though something kept stopping her. Due to her own reasons that weren't shared, her parents didn't allow her to get along with animals. Yet Caitlin was unstoppable and worked with animal rescue organizations and wildlife rehabilitation processes. Though she had house pets and round-bellied pig and a horse she loved to ride on as a child, she didn't have much knowledge and experience with them. The journey she started wasn't easy at all, but Caitlin was determined to manage it. Before we take you on Caitlin's amazing journey, it's important for you to know that since childhood she'd faced a hard time with animals compared to the rest of us. "I'm just highly allergic to animals, all of them except chickens," Caitlin explained further. "I knew way before I started the rescue and working with animals in general that I had a terrible physical reaction to them. Swollen lips, rashes were never enough to keep her away from animals any size, big or small. Wild or pet, she was sure to rescue them as she felt it was the mission of her life." And it began in 2010 when Caitlin made up her mind to rescue one animal from slaughter. A wild Mustang was being transported from Nevada through the US government, most probably to be solved. Caitlin, with her friend Amy, an animal advocate, was getting into this without second thoughts, which were very unlikely for them. "I suppose one would say that fate is not held back by natural human instinct in most cases," said Caitlin. She was getting into a chain that'll keep moving for a lifetime and will positively affect many souls at the same time. In this picture, Halona, the white horse Caitlin rescued, is in a far better situation than she was found in. Caitlin named her Halona, which means beautiful choice, and was about to give Caitlin a hard time. Caitlin was looking for a place where Halona could live with her in a backyard and get the proper attention she needs. She looked for more than 50 properties and found nothing. She took a break from everything, and right at that moment she realized she should look for more horses that needed to be rescued and she was willing to adopt. This would result in Halona having many friends with her in the perfect backyard. She got to know about a beautiful gelding who retired early from racing and was recently rescued from being slaughtered. She called the owner and soon went to New Jersey to meet Jake, the thoroughbred, whose one overwhelming eye contact was enough for Caitlin, and she said, "I'd love to give him a home, please." Halona now had a companion, Jake, but no place to live yet. Caitlin asked if Jake's caretaker Lisa could let Jake stay a little longer until she found a place. The reply from the other side she got was strange, and Caitlin didn't believe Lisa when she said, "We can work out the details. Are you looking for a farm? You can get mine." But Caitlin was sure that Lisa's property looked quite unaffordable for her budget. However, the same evening, Lisa emailed a makeshift offer, enlisting all the required information about the farm. In no time, Caitlin managed to buy her farm and adopt Jake. Adopting wild horses might look like an adventurous task, but what everyone forgets is with adventure comes danger and hardships too. "She was the ultimate test for me. I had broken fingers, she cracked my ribs, it was really intense. I'll admit I regretted the adoption at first. I don't think I fully understood how wild she was. I cried all the time, I felt so defeated because she was so difficult." Caitlin explains how hard it was for her and Halona to get along as she was in trauma. It was hard for her to trust Caitlin and added, "She was a wild Mustang running the wild plains and she was rounded up by the government and I rescued her from going to slaughter. Whenever a helicopter would fly over, she'd freak out because that's how they spot and capture wild horses. It was really scary and just traumatic all around." Caitlin talked about Halona's condition, who was not yet ready to give up on her beautiful choice. The results of her efforts are now visible. Today, Halona is the most affectionate animal closest to Caitlin. Caitlin named her new farm Ranch Relaxo, as it denotes a place for mental relaxation. She's managed to keep it true to its name. She works for animal rights, and every animal staying in Ranch Relaxo is treated with respect and generosity. Caitlin's never looked back since her first rescue, and according to her, she realizes it's not enough, and someone out there is still in need of her help. So she gave it a wonderful start with Ranch Relaxo. The red, blue, yellow, white, and green Buddhist prayer flags hanging in Ranch Relaxo are very meaningful for Caitlin, as it depicts peace and spreads the prayers everywhere with the wind. Caitlin is surely a person who lives a reasonable life and follows her ethics, which definitely made her win over the hearts of many who saw the honesty and appreciation in her work. Since the day she started her farm life and engaged in it completely, she began gaining more knowledge about horses that are bound to get slaughtered. She started knowing the situations of other animals too. And her amazing neighbors Donna and Clarence gave her a trio of old hens as her housewarming gift. Soon she learned chickens are very social animals with strong instincts. Later, she started working with other rescue organizations and started helping with transport. Caitlin devoted her life entirely to the animals that she rescues every now and then. She gives them their rights in this place, like nourishment and love. She looked into kill shelter puppies and kittens as well before they landed in forever homes. My mission was clear the day I drove out to a man's home who had two pot-bellied pigs listed on Craigslist headed to an auction, advertised as food for exotic animals. When I arrived, his children were throwing rocks at the babies, laughing about it as if it were normal to behave that way towards innocent creatures. The piglets were scared and Caitlin felt miserable and says that it was for her. Animals needed a voice somehow and I was going to be the one to give it to them. Until the day I die, that's what I was going to do. Pictured, Britney Spears. Britney Spears is a pony, i.e. a little horse that was rescued by Caitlin when she was informed through social media by one of her followers about her underweight and pathetic living conditions. She wasn't fed and Caitlin successfully proved it on the basis of medical reports. As it was clear, now Britney was legally adopted by Caitlin over her previous owners. Britney, now married, also saved Pepito and is living a lavish life. Leonard Simoni, treasurer of Board and Animal Caregiver, was always supportive of Caitlin's work and recalls. After connecting with Caitlin, the founder of Rancho Relaxo, Leonard came to realize how imperative it was to advocate for animals. He was a physics student, but his unprecedented and determined attitude kept him going. After his first rescue with Caitlin of Pepito, a miniature donkey, who was to be sent to slaughter, his whole life changed, but just like Caitlin, he wasn't ready to give up. I remember working non-stop and I didn't even have $100 in my savings account. I lived on veggie ramen noodles, remembers Caitlin. She was doing what she was born to do, yet she lacked sponsors and was left with nothing of her own. But as it is said, where there's a will, there's a way. She was sure to figure out a way, and soon she did, and the response that she was soon to receive was more than she ever expected. In the picture is the calf named Chester, whom they'd rescued together. Ryan Gouveia, secretary of Board and Animal Caregiver, walked into Rancho Relaxo for a photo shoot with animals and trashed the wedding dress. The photo shoot never took place, but Ryan consistently worked with them with some time given to training. She worked hard and showed interest of off-site events, too. Another person also made Rancho Relaxo her purpose and was highly motivated. Cameron Sklavos Gillette, another lover of animals too, joined as she worked for various animal care programs before she didn't require any training, and soon got along with the helping and caring environment of the farm. The team was growing and so was their support. A group of people working together for a better future of these animals was the best example the world could get at the time. Karen and Gustav Stewart, Caitlin and Justin Bast, and a few more were now working for a sole aim. Henry Fisher, who added on his part by using his carpentry skills. Jessica Andrilovich, who worked as a content writer for the farm, spreading the word all over. Erica Smargisso, who works 20 hours weekly for the animals, who in return love her the most. Eric Johnson, who worked for Saving Dogs, came all the way from Florida, but didn't just join but helped and took full responsibility of Elmer, a piglet, and they took a few weeks to become best buddies. I just couldn't stop. I didn't stop. I just filtered all the money into the rescue and surprisingly, we've become self-sufficient as a rescue, thanks to all the good people that support us. It's phenomenal. It's strength through numbers. Caitlin worked day and night for her animals who were treated as her kids. They expanded and got more land to rescue more and start an adoption center. The journey that began with a wild Mustang was now expanding every day with her increasing efforts and her kind nature that touched a huge number of donors with the help of GoFundMe awareness website. The effect was so much that they exceeded their fund's target, making Caitlin a heroic figure. It means more than I can ever say. I tell people that if you like what a nonprofit does, give them $1. They have no idea how far $1 can go. We're so grateful for every penny we get. Overwhelmed, Sim and I expressed her emotions. She has an expense of $4,000 monthly just for food. From millions of little heartbeats growing and playing in Rancho Relaxo, few are quite famous among them all. Let's move on to those. Clover was a rescue lamb with severe health conditions, weak eyesight, and a crooked jaw and bow legs that made it more difficult for her. But Caitlin gave the neglected Clover a second chance to live. The couple drove 90 minutes every week to a vet who could help Clover with a leg problem. Caitlin recalls her progress and how everyone was impressed. Sadly, one night during a thunderstorm, and as the thunder frightens most of the animals, and especially Clover's heart, was weak due to the illness, she couldn't survive and died of a heart attack. 3 weeks later, though, Caitlin noticed Clover's growing in the same spot where Clover spent her last night. I feel like Clover's energy left that for me and was like, okay, go on another rescue mission and shut up. And that inspired Caitlin. Another caring and soulful creature, Batman could rightly be called a therapy piglet at Rancho Relaxo. Batman is our rescued orphan piglet. He's less than 2 weeks old now and he's been extra attached to Sriracha today. I swear he knows she has a bad couple of days and feels the need to comfort her. The kitten has been suffering from feline cerebellar hypoplasia since her birth, due to which she gets breakdowns that can be very painful. But Batman the piglet came to her rescue. Fortunately, when Batman eventually passed away due to complications, someone else stood by Sriracha. As Dragon Lord warmed up to me over the last 24 hours, I realized he's his own little person, and although he's blood related to Batman, he's completely different. Dragon Lord took to Sriracha even better than Batman did. Caitlin shared this message on social media. Dragon Lord is Batman's orphan sibling and now continues to look after the kitten just like his brother did. A 30-year-old starved senior horse was being sent to slaughter when the couple intervened. They just looked at his picture and his old bony body cried for the love and attention he needed. The couple drove an hour and successfully took him to their ranch by evening. As he didn't have many teeth left, Caitlin soaks his food grains every day to help him and named him Grandpa Pancakes, a senior member of the Rancho Relaxo family. Then Alba. Caitlin explained she spent 8 weeks being tested on. From 1 week old to 8 weeks old, she was burn tested on. When you agree to take an animal from these laboratories, you're basically agreeing to non-disclosure. I'm not allowed to say what kind of product was tested, whether it was a cleaning product or medical based. I'm not even allowed to say what state she came from. Alba, who's now a much happier pig, Caitlin says, if she did have trauma, you'd never know it. Her personality's just unbelievable. She's so loving and still so trusting of people. She'd met three of the pigs who live at her sanctuary, Elmer, Martha, and Linda. She's gotten along great with Elmer, the little male pot-bellied pig, but Martha and Linda have been a little bit snooty. They're like, who's this girl? Caitlin further adds, the dogs love her, and she loves the dogs, she loves all of our caretakers. Her personality is so powerful, but so soft. She lays on her side and asks for belly scratches. She's just amazing. Dean joined Rancho Relaxo when his mother rejected him as she was unable to produce milk due to her old age. Dean was very weak when he first arrived, but the little one showed improvements with every new day. Now he's loved by every animal on the ranch and he himself goes to meet all his farm friends roaming around. Good deeds never go to waste, and so Caitlin was receiving support not just from Americans but across the oceans as well. Her efforts were being appreciated and donations are continuously made by people for whom she's a source of inspiration. The girl even started a goat yoga thing. In an interview by Rob Solomon, GoFundMe CEO said, Caitlin is doing incredible selfless work with animals in need, and I'm thrilled she's been chosen as our latest GoFundMe hero. As a fellow animal lover, it's been inspiring to see how Caitlin has used GoFundMe to further her mission of giving abandoned animals the second chance they deserve. What they do to my spirit outweighs what they do to my skin, said Caitlin. We like to have a volunteer center, and just have it be an educational experience as well, and the people can come, volunteer, and then can do tours. The couple stands together in tough times and is hoping to expand their 16-acre property. Now, Caitlin is regularly on heavy medication due to her allergies. In the past, this led to her being hospitalized in the ER twice. Her asthma attacks make it worse for her as she couldn't breathe at all. She had blisters because of her allergies, but she keeps her spirits up and is finding ways to deal with it. Now that she takes care of herself, as staying away from her farm family isn't an option. She sure has made an impact of kindness in the world, running behind money. In her words, you're born with a life mission and it's been imprinted on me, and I didn't realize until I woke up one morning and I'm like, oh, I basically started a rescue.